To pop on here first before we jump into our exercises and just kind of explain how full body circuit usually works at the studio if you've never taken one of my classes there. Yes, at the studio we do have more weight options and machines that we can use, but I've picked out some fun body weight exercises and also ones where you'll just need a dumbbell or a chair, something like that. So we'll still get that heart rate up, get some sweat going with these exercises. So at the studio, we usually do three rounds. We do 40-20, 45-15, and 50-10. We have eight exercises that we rotate stations through. So what I'm gonna do is just do individual videos that I will splice together in one full video for you. If you're not able to do it in that interval format, you can always just do 10 reps of each exercise and do it for the three rounds. And I also just want to say that if any of you don't feel comfortable with some of these exercises, feel free to personal message me and I'll find a different modification for you. I don't want anyone to feel discouraged. I want to try to give as many modifications as I can so that everyone can participate in this and have fun. So let's go ahead and get started. That we're going to do in this full body circuit is a two-way curl to a floor burpee. So I'll show you a couple different options for you here. So how I'm going to do it in the video, I'll just go ahead and demonstrate that first. So first, we're gonna do a traditional curl, come down, hammer curl, and then we're gonna drop the weights down, go all the way to the floor in that burpee, and we're gonna pop up and no jump. So once again, we're gonna curl to the top, down, switch, hammer curl, down, weight on the floor, down all the way on the ground, back up. So some modifications for that is you can completely eliminate the burpee if you want to and just focus on that full body. So that would be the bicep curl, hammer curl, just going back and forth with those, keeping the biceps nice and engaged. We're not swinging the weights everywhere. Another option is you can do the curls, and instead of dropping completely to the floor, you can just step back with each leg and then step forward and back up to the top. So I'm gonna go ahead and start the timer. Curling up, curling again, down to the floor for that burpee. When you're popping back up, really try to focus on not leaning too much on those knees. You want to just jump back with your toes.
Hey, this is Lizzo. Tap now to listen to my
second exercise is going to be a plank jack with tricep kickback. So what that's gonna look like is we are going to have our hands on our weights. We'll be in a high plank position. We're gonna do our plank jack, and then we're gonna row up, tricep kickback, up, tricep kickback, and we're back into another high plank. So a couple more options here. If you wanna eliminate that high plank, you can just use your knees on the ground, row up, into that tricep kickback, back down, row up, tricep kickback, and down. If you prefer not to be on the floor at all, you can always do a jack, and then you can come up with those triceps and kick back. Here we go, plank jack, row up, tricep kickback, up, tricep kickback, and back to that plank jack. Nice and controlled movements with your arms. Notice it's running like crazy. Almost there, 10 more seconds. Our third and fourth exercise is going to be a static hold chest press with a glute bridge. So I am going to use the couch to help with that glute bridge. And like I said, I'll give a couple of different options if you're not really feeling this. So I'm going to use my back up here. I'm gonna keep those glutes nice and squeezed. When you're holding your dumbbells, make sure your wrists are not rolled back. You want your knuckles nice and forward so that we're not pressing those in. So I'm gonna hold my left arm up for the first round, and then I'll switch over to my right arm. So we will just press up, nice, slow, and controlled down. We're not really gonna get as much range of motion as if we were on a bench. But remember, the whole time I want you to maintain that glute bridge as well, so we're working our chest and our bottom. If you don't feel comfortable doing that glute bridge on the couch, you can always do this exercise on the floor. So once again, we're holding that weight up, and then we are going to pump the other weight up and down for a full round. Here we go. I'm going to go ahead and switch sides on this one. Going to be a pike plank to shoulder push-up. So what I'm actually going to be using for this one are going to be little paper plates just to give me some extra resistance, a little bit more challenge, and to work my abs a little bit more. But I'll show you some modifications that will not require any paper plates at all. So I'm going to set my toes on each of the plates. I'm going to bring my hands over this cloth right here and have them spread so that my head is going to be in between my shoulders. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to squeeze up into that pike position, and then I'm going to be looking down in between my legs as I go down as low as I can in that shoulder push-up. So once again, we're going to bring it back out, squeeze those abs to the top, and then we're going to go as low as we can with that shoulder push-up. Some modifications, we can just focus on doing shoulder push-ups without the pike. So once again, hands are gonna be over that rag. We're going to get into a pike position. I like to go a little bit wider for these, it helps me some. And then looking between your feet, you're gonna try to go as low as you can. This is really gonna work those shoulders. It's gonna be challenging, but it'll be fun. If you're not feeling up to that, we can always just get into a high plank position and work on stretching into a pike plank. So we'll be in that high plank. We're just gonna stretch back as far as we can, and then we're gonna come back to that high plank. So stretching back, we're still working our core, working those shoulders. Let's go ahead and get started. exercise, you're going to need a chair, or you can use a kitchen counter, anything that can you can help prop yourself up on. So this is going to be a standing leg curl to elbow tuck. So we're going to just rest our hand here. We're going to kind of lean into it a little bit. So we'll bring our arm and leg up. We're going to curl that leg back, and then we're going to bring our knee and elbow together. So leg is back stretched out, curl the leg back, touch the knee to the elbow. We're going to do that on both sides. Go ahead and start. So arm and leg is out, bending the knee back, crunching in. Back out, bend, crunching in. Really feeling it in that glute, ladies. Ten more seconds on this side. And rest, switch over to that other side. I'm just gonna move my chair over and do both of these together. Starting in 5 seconds. Push this back a little bit. Remember, we're leaning into it a little bit. So both go up, back, tuck. Booty burn. Loving this one. Cool brain fart there for a second. And we're done with that one. For this next exercise, we're going to be doing incline skier jumps. So I have my chair, and I also have it pushed into the couch right here. Since we're gonna be moving a little bit, I don't want my chair sliding. I wanna just be safe and have everything nice and controlled. So I recommend you do the same. We're gonna take each end right here. We're gonna come out to the side, and then we're going to jump up to the side, back, and then up to the other side. So a faster version, we're jumping in and up. Really working that core. A modified version is you can still do the incline and hold onto a chair. I want you to take the leg closest to the outside and stretch it out really far. Bring that other leg in or back out. So stretch that right leg out, and then we're back in. I can also show you a regular way to do it without the incline. So we would be in a high plank position. And we are just going to be going up, and back. Or like the modification, you can step to the side, step to the side, step back, then step to the side again.